All right, time now is 11:13 on April 12th. Pepper should be back in LA by now, so we can hang out. But unfortunately, I still haven't received that call. I'm still waiting for that phone call, man. I'm still waiting for that phone call. Yeah, today's gonna be a cool day because I will be meeting JT and Potter at Sawtelle, which is right outside the door. I'm not in a rush. All right, another morning, another Krispy Kreme. Let's go. Holy crap. It's so windy outside. It was like blowing leaves. All right. Here we go. Looking nice. I'm gonna go live.呢啲餐廳一嚿麵包60蚊。我講笑咧，我話呢啲餐廳一嚿麵包60蚊。
560蚊？
都60蚊。我講笑啫，因為呢度好似好貴，所以都。
所以咪要翻工咯，所以咪要賺錢。
所以要犯法。我幾興奮啊！犯法，
即係我覺得係你翻咗工之後咧，你就會覺得
你忙好多，你冇咁得閒咁多手。
係，你唔會諗咁多狗屎嘅，唔會諗咁多狗屁。我記得前面有一間咧係，
Criterion Collection. Holy fuck, guys. Yo, what the heck? I need to get down and see the Criterion Collection. Oh my god. Oh my god, Criterion. Oh my god. Holy shit. There's another one on the other side. This is insane. Holy shit. Oh my god. Oh. This is insane. Touch of Zen. Shit. Yeah. Oh my god. Oh, Tokyo Drifter, I need to watch this. Amazing. Fantastic Mr. Fox. Oh, Abox Kiarostami. Citizen Kane 4K. Good shit. Good shit. Funny games. What the fuck? They got Qui-Don and Criterion? I didn't know that. I thought it's only Eureka. Fellini, La Strada, La N, La Ventura. Holy shit. Is there a high end? Oh! Oh my god. Yume. Yume. Hunger by Steve McQueen. It's in Criterion? Holy crap. Bansun. Ozu Yashiro. This is insane. Kuro Neko. No fucking way. No fucking way. No fucking way. F for fake. Holy shit. Holy shit. There's more! Oh, it's just not Criterion's. Okay, wow. Oh! God damn, can I find Radiohead here? Wouldn't that be sick? Dr. Dre. Childish Gambino. Come on, seriously? Girl in Red? Taylor Swift. Wow. Oh, Japanese breakfast. Sufjan Stevens. Where's the 69? Where's the 69? Oh, come on. Where's the 69? Where's the 69? Come on. Yes, I found it. 69. Yes. Oh my god. Ooh, My Chemical Romance. Wow, Pink Floyd. Okay, come on. Oh man. No Radiohead. Bro, what is this, bro? God damn, Mononoke, yes, Mononoke Hime. Whoa, Weathering with You. Let's go! Fucking thirsty. Oh my god. I need to drink something. Give me this. kill me already. Just kill me right now.
Feel 唔 feel 到？平時自己整嘅，我近排中意自己整沙律。好啦，凍啦，點樣攞帽
？Fuck you! Fuck you! All right, time now is.8:18 p.m. I'm late again for dinner, but that's okay because nobody, I got no time constraints. I'm gonna go home, cook myself dinner, and yeah, interesting, slightly, mildly interesting day. Today is a mildly, very, very mildly, slightly, tiny, small, interesting day. No, can I even call it interesting? It's not boring, but it's not very interesting. It's just a very normal day, plus with a dash of interest. A dash. I don't know. First time cooking eggplants. Yes.Let's try to do the dishwasher. This is the first time I've ever used the dishwasher in my life. So, the first time for everything. Get a pack of this. Ooh, very, very solid. Very sticky. This is different from the clothes washing stuff. Put it here. Slide it. Oh, shit. Arr, mamma mia. Okay.Let's put it back. And then I do this. Select cycle. Fuck, what do I do? Steam. No steam. Wash temperature. Boost sani. I don't know what either means. Okay, and then start.Yes, begin the washing. Yes, woohoo. So at around 1:30, Potter showed up outside of my apartment. Not outside of the door of my apartment unit, but the whole building. He's just sitting right outside. And he's right there. And so I met up with him, and, you know, right off the bat, he didn't even say hi. It was all cool and all. With long hair about until here. He looks like Levi from Attack on Titan, except hair is a little bit longer. And he's all cool, and he's like, "Do you have a portable charger?" And I said, "Yeah, I do." So I gave one to him, and he said it doesn't work because he's using an Apple, and I use an Android portable charger. All right, so we sat down, and, you know, it's like, "Hey, what's up? You know, how's it going?" So I asked him, you know, like, why do you need to charge your phone? He said, "Well, it's 3%. I stayed overnight at a friend's place," and I'm like, "Oh, that's cool." And I asked, "Do you not charge your phone at your friend's place?" And then he said, "Yeah, I did, but I guess it didn't work very well." So I'm like, "Okay, I see." So right off the bat, even though I'm happy for him for having friends. But this actually made me feel a little sad because I never got to hang out with friends all that much, let alone stay overnight at a friend's place. And then after a while, he asked me how I've been, and I said, you know, the usuals. I've been looking for a place, went to the Airbnb, moved to a new apartment, just college. That's it. Nothing else. You know, going to Ralph's, buying food, going to Target, buying house things. That's it. My life is not that interesting. And then JT showed up, and then JT decided to call an Uber. While we were waiting for an Uber, JT's like, "Hi, how's it going?" And Potter's like, "Yeah, great." And Potter asked JT for a portable charger. JT took hers. And it works because it's an Apple portable charger. And then, you know, Potter explained, "Oh, I was staying overnight at a friend's place." And then JT's like, yeah, you know. "Oh, last night I was also with a friend. I was singing karaoke with two Korean friends and a boyfriend of the Korean friend. It's a lot of fun. I sung a lot, so my voice is a little raspy today. I'm sorry about that." And they were just talking about, "Wow, I got this friend, I got that friend. Oh, I met this Japanese dude and he's very nice. And there's this Taiwanese girl and she's also my friend, blah, 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 blah." And they were just talking about having friends and having fun. And I was just sitting at the very left side and I was like looking away and I was just like, I feel so bad. I feel so fucking bad. Like, I mean, don't get me wrong, man. I got friends too. I mean, I got JT and Potter to start off. But I also got Pepper, I guess. I mean, I'm hanging out with Christian. I watched Batman with him. I hung out with Eric for a little bit. But I don't know. A, I just don't have enough friends as them. B, I'm nowhere near, like, I've never had fun with friends. Like, "Oh yeah, we hung out, we went hiking together, we had dinner together. Oh yeah, we hung out and we went shopping, we went to the beach. And oh, we didn't invite you because you're not important, because you don't deserve fun like we do. You deserve to be alone. We didn't invite you because we forgot about you, because we don't need you, because we don't need you in our lives, because you're not important, because you're useless, because you're a loser. Because you're weird." I get this feeling again. And I just keep, while they were happily talking about, "Oh, yeah, I hung out last night. I hung out last week. This friend, that friend. Oh, I met a guy in my class. I met a guy in this club. I met this girl. I met this blah, blah, blah." All in my head, I was thinking how much of a loser I am. How alone, how lonely and how goddamn depressing and miserable my life has been. How about me? Did I hang out? Did I have fun with anyone? Hell fucking no. I went to Ralph's and I went to Target. That's the most I did. I mean, I went to UCLA to watch Revolution over time. And again, honestly, my situation isn't even that bad. Like, in comparison with my own situation in secondary school, like, me right now is actually doing way better. Like, way, way, way better. You have no idea. And as hard as I try to change that, I will never succeed. I will always remain miserable. I'm in USA right now. I'm in LA right now. I try my best. I speak to people. I socialize. I do. But I still remain miserable. Because I always do remain miserable. Because that's in me. I will always be miserable. No matter what I do, no matter where I am, no matter when is it, I will always be miserable. I'm destined to be miserable. It's like a curse. It's like a curse that cannot be broken. I needed something more. Like, I needed... I don't know why. I still feel missed out, despite the fact that I've hung out with Zara and Miriam and went to Central and Mong Kok with them. Despite the fact that I had the hot pot lunch with Natalie before I left. I still feel missed out. I still feel like these hangouts aren't, like, main enough for me. I don't know why, like, I want to be in the beach event. When Natalie, Queenie, Harry, when Leo, Leo wasn't there, when Pink and Kingsley, when they were in the beach event, I wish I was invited. I wish I was invited. If I was there, maybe I would feel more included. And then my second thought is, maybe there is no ultimate goal. Maybe whatever I do, maybe even if I join like a giant group of friends of 30 people and hang out and party and karaoke and go to the beach and whatever, maybe even so, I will not feel included. I will still feel missed out. And I would not feel fun. If you tell me to go to the beach, if you tell me to go to some fancy ass mall and just walk, I would just feel bored. I don't get entertained. There's nothing entertaining. There's nothing pleasurable about walking in the mall. There's nothing pleasurable about walking in the beach. Maybe to you it's nice. Maybe to you you'll be fun. Ooh, nice restaurant, nice store. Ooh, I don't do that. I've lost the ability to feel pleasure. And this, the idea of that just makes me feel so painful. And then, yeah, again, we went to the farmer's market, we sat down, I bought the grilled chicken burrito, and I didn't bring a water bottle, so my mouth is literally burrito. I have burrito mouth, okay? And I had to keep wearing the mask, and it was a mess. I forgot to grab the napkins, aka the tissues, so there's sauce on this corner of my mouth, and, like, it was windy, so a small cup of sauce, like, poured, and a bit fell onto my phone. And, like, my mask flew on the floor like it was a mess. And, you know, JT and Potter, they're hanging out. Potter didn't order anything. He's not eating food today. JT ate a breakfast burrito. And, you know, they're both, like, chilling, hanging out. Yeah, you know, friends, food, haha, nice. And I'm just there, like, fucking suffering. And then after that, we just walked to the Grove, which is a very fancy touristy place that looks like Disneyland. It's the, like, very nice floors, music playing, nice lamppost. There's a tram running through, like, goddamn. It's, why is it so fancy? How expensive is this place? What happened to this place? And at that point, I was still feeling really miserable. Like, I just fucking hate everything and everyone, really. Like, I feel detached from people. And Potter and JT were both like, oh, then maybe it's not about communication, but socializing. Like, you're not good at socializing. And I'm like, yeah, maybe. And then I just feel fucking awful. So, like, we're walking around the Grove, and it's a nice place, but I just feel, like, detached. I don't fucking care about anything. Until we walked into a bookstore and I saw the Criterion stand and I'm like, oh, oh, oh. And then I ran down the escalator and then I checked out the Criterions and I feel stuck. So at that point, it's just me holding, I didn't even wear a mask, but it was me holding my mask and my drink. And then just in front of me, like 6-7 steps in front of me, is just Potter And JT just hanging out, chatting, like, haha, oh, look at this house, look at this thing, haha, how's life, blah, 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 blah. And I'm just in the back, just like a loser, basically, just following them. And it's like, and I just keep thinking, like, wow, they're having fun, but I'm suffering, they're having fun, I'm suffering, they're having fun, I'm suffering, they're having fun, I'm suffering. And the more I, like, trail behind them, the more unimportant I feel. I feel unimportant. I feel small. I feel left behind. Literally left behind. I'm literally behind them. And they don't really, like, turn around and go, oh, Enoch, why are you so far back? Join us. Like, they don't do that. They just keep talking and chatting. Ha ha ha. Life is good. Life is good. And I'm just in the back. Fuck you. Fuck me. Fuck everything. And I'm, like, one of those, like, emo sad characters that just is unable to make any social interactions whatsoever. But yeah, at one point in the clothes store, Potter suddenly turned to me and go, oh, look at this shirt, it's made in Hong Kong. And I'm like, what? And I don't know why, it's so easy, because he randomly spoke to me, I felt a little bit better. I'm like, yeah, haha, it is made in Hong Kong. That's weird. And then I started to actually check out clothes. And even though I still don't care about clothes, I started to, you know, check out. Like, haha, nice color, nice shirt, nice texture. I don't fucking care. Okay, we went to another clothes store, blah, 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 yada, yada. After leaving the clothes store, it was late. It was like 6 something. The sun is setting. We gotta go back home and avoid the traffic. So JT's like, okay, let's leave. So JT's calling another Uber. So while we were waiting for the Uber, it is now time for some personal confessions. And I told them, because a little earlier when I was eating the grilled chicken burrito, I was like, making friends is so damn difficult for me. Like, every time I talk to someone, I feel like I'm playing chess. Because I need to know what line to say next. I need to know how the conversation is directed. I need to know how do I get a certain reaction? How do I say a certain sentence? How do I reach a goal? Like socializing is so difficult because it's like playing chess. And Potter's like, well, I think you're a little bit overthinking. You're overthinking a little bit. I think you're a bit in your own head. And JT heard, and JT says, I agree. And then I said, me too. I genuinely agree with the fact that I think too much. And that is pretty much my personality. I overthink everything. And sometimes I try to not overthink everything, but I still end up doing it because I can't help myself. So I honestly wish I don't overthink everything. I wish I don't. But later, while waiting for that Uber, I clarified. To be honest, I don't think socializing with people is like playing chess, because sometimes I answer and respond to people naturally. So it's not like chess, but it's like going into a tunnel. Socializing is like going into a tunnel. There are just so many unknowns. It's like gambling. You know, I speak to Thomas and I also talk about short films. Let's work on a short film together. Cool. But how? What's going to happen? Are we going to have creative differences, thus not working together ever again, which kind of happened already? Like, there's so much uncertainty. Like, I hang out with Pepper. I'm like, hey, man. Hey, Pepper. Let's have lunch. You know, let's hang out. Psych. Pepper may go to UC Riverside. She may go to San Francisco and never return, and or maybe she will, but we're going to be separated. So every time I start a new conversation with a stranger, every time I start a new conversation with someone, every time I start socializing with someone, I'm gambling. And there's just so much uncertainties. We're going to grow apart, okay? You're going to leave me at some point. We're going to grow apart. Said goodbye to JT, and then it's just me and Potter. And Potter took out his little weed electronic blunt. E-blunt. And I thought it's just a vape, honestly. I thought it's like an e-cigarette, but no. He later told me that there's weed inside. So I'm like, oh. Oh, so that was weed. Okay. And he started talking about how for his designing class in college, he needs to design a costume that is inspired by a sculpture. You know, when Potter told me he slept over at a friend's at first today, this morning, I thought, my God, is it like a female friend? What happened? I don't want to know. But it's a Japanese guy. But that's so cool. You got other East Asian friends. I wish I'd do that. Other than Thomas. But culturally, he ain't even East Asian. He ain't even. I mean, I have feelings. I'm not aromantic, because I love Mary. I'm capable of romance or loving someone. And I'm capable of having feelings for people. Like, I miss my family. And when my dad and my brother got COVID, I was legitimately worried about them. You know, I like Cedric and Natalie as friends. I miss them. I miss hanging out with them. It's been 3 years since we've hung out. I'm not kidding. Three. But I don't know why. I feel like I've lost the ability to have pleasure, to just enjoy anything other than movies and music at this point. So I still have a kind of this sense of nothing I do will give me pleasure. Nothing I do will make me feel like I'm not missing out. But you know what? Despite feeling miserable, I will keep going. I have to. Level 2 resumes. Alright. Hey guys, what's up? It's the Cultured Man here. It's 11:58 a.m. on April 13th. And, I don't know. Still no news from anyone else. So Potter wants to speak to me, like hang out with me in a cafe and continue to talk about his project. His sculpture costume latex project. The emo Fallen Angels inspired latex costume music video project thing. And I'm like, I want to rest today, so I won't go out. But, you know, tomorrow, I guess. Alright, this is the final donut. Here we go. Is there nothing inside? Nope. There's supposed to be something inside. I think it has a bit of cream. Okay. Got the bread, got the cheese. That's already 330 calories. Now, let's do this. And then let's do this. God damn it. Oh, fuck. Okay, God damn it. Voila. Like, who backs down, man? You either back down like a loser and you give up, or you keep fighting with all your might and all your will. And I'm sorry, man. I will be doing the latter. I will fight. I will fight for friends. I I don't know why. I like being real. I like being honest. I'm an honest guy. So last night when, or yesterday when I hung out with JT and Potter, and while we were waiting for the Uber at Melrose Avenue, I actually spoke to them both, specifically to Potter, but JT heard it, about getting a girlfriend. I said, I feel like, because I mentioned Pepper, because I feel like out of all the Hong Kongers I've known, and it's not like I know a lot, but out of all of them, the one that I can relate to and I can hang out the most, I feel like, is Pepper. She's the nicest. And so Potter's like, what, are you having fantasies about her? And I'm like, no, that's a mistake. In fact, it's the opposite. I don't feel anything for anyone now. I feel detached from everyone. I don't love anyone romantically now, other than Mary. But then again, Mary's gone and I've kind of let her go already. But the fact of the matter is, I don't think I'll be able to find a girlfriend anytime soon. And then JT hopped in. JT said, oh, a lot of my friends ask me, you know, after I've gone to LA, have you gotten a boyfriend yet? And I said no, and my friends are like kind of surprised. Because apparently a lot of people immediately outpool, aka get a romantic partner, right after, like immediately after they have arrived in another country. There's me. Now, I don't want to make this about girlfriends and boyfriends and all that stuff, because again, that is not a goal. Not something that I should aggressively work towards on. I will aggressively work towards on friends because that relies on me. That depends on me. But girlfriend is something different. Girlfriend isn't just about me. It's about the world. And if I force myself to, it's just going to ruin it because I'm not supposed to. I realized that JT's gained so many followers because JT's just asking for IG all the time. And actually, I just remembered that on December 15th, when I and JT first met, she immediately asked me for my IG before I even asked her. I think, right? Yeah, she asked me first, like on that day. So maybe I should just start doing that. For starters, just ask for people's Instagram left and right without hesitation. I mean, I asked for Christian's Instagram. I should ask for everyone else as well. Like, Potter even told me yesterday that, you know, to socialize, you really need to, you know, dudes talk some bullshit, basically. Hi, how are you? How are you doing? Wow, so cool, so amazing. You have to do all this stuff because that's called socializing, especially in a place like LA. Where everybody's fake. You gotta do it, man. You just gotta do it. Put on an act. You can do it. I can do it. I can do it. You can do it. So, establish a channel. Go to Instagram. See an interesting Instagram story. Yo, DM. Organize some stuff. So that's step one. I'm going to be very calculated about this, like I said. And you watch me go, boy. You watch me go. You witness me go, okay? Okay. Bro, is that too much? I feel like that's too much. Yep, definitely too much sauce. God damn it. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do now. Okay. Let's go. High heat. And then I got one more bacon in the fridge, and then I'm gonna get some spinach salad. maybe on a separate bowl, maybe on this plate, I don't know. There we go, got the beef really cooked. I poured some water because some water went out of the beef into the pan. Rigatoni salad. Try this. It's all right. It's just okay. Let's try the beef. Tastes good, but definitely cooked for too long. Why do I enjoy hanging out with Leo and Pink? Why? Because they're nice. Because they are tolerable of me. Like, if I act weird, they don't think I'm weird. And they are accepting of me. Okay, why do I hang out with Natalie? Natalie is like the opposite of Leo and Pink. Natalie doesn't accept me when I act weird. Natalie's weird herself, and Natalie's not a nice person. Then why do I want to hang out with Natalie? For other reasons. And I need to ask myself questions like this. I need to analyze, like, why do I want to hang out with Pepper? Honestly, out of Pepper, JT, and Potter, Pepper is the one I want to hang out the most. Why? Because common interests? Because we both love movies? Maybe. Because we both have the same political ideology? Maybe. But so does Potter. Alright, time now is 12:20. I feel satisfied. Just drew for about an hour. And I feel like there's been an improvement. Even though I'm still a long way from actually being able to draw. But there's an improvement. Wow, I am popping off, baby. I am popping off. Again, I'm saying this not because I want to brag. I still hate myself. But I'm just saying that I've mastered level 1. And I can master level 1. Now I'm taking on level 2. And I need to have some confidence. So, yeah, that's all.